Ready? Twin bells. Good afternoon. My name's Mike Hebard. I'm the owner of this rather nice machine. It's a 1937 Leyland turntable ladder fire engine. The engine on this is a petrol engine. It does 4 miles to the gallon, which is not a lot. Quite a thirsty brute. And the design goes back to the very late 1920s. It was new to London Fire Brigade in April 1937. It was one of a pair that was supplied, the first of this type, to London Fire Brigade. The ladder itself is German make. It's of Metz origin. It's 101 foot in length when fully extended, or 30 meters for those who don't understand feet and inches. And it can travel in a full 360 degrees when elevated. This vehicle served at Soho fire station from April 1937 right through to April 1964, which is a long time, and it really was a hard-working station. And that was Soho's pre-war code. Soho fire station is situated in the west end of London. And the station itself had three vehicles. It had a turntable ladder pump, which is this one, and the pump is here. They also had a pump escape. That was a vehicle with a big wheeled escape. Wheels which were 6 foot in diameter, and that ladder could be taken off the vehicle and extended to 50 foot or 15 meters, I should say. They also had a basic pump, which had a big pump on it for pumping lots of water. The pump escape and the pump carried water. This vehicle does not carry any water at all. When it came out of service in 1964, it had done some 31,000 miles, which for this type of vehicle is a lot of mileage. The average for a turntable ladder in a city or a town would be something like, I should think, 7,000 to 10,000 miles in its lifetime. This is basically the safety indicator. As it elevates, this will stay still, but the gauge, so that means at 30 degrees you can have 59 foot extension and one man on it, or 53 with two. In here, this ball is a plumb bob. These are the controls to operate the ladder. This is the throttle. This one trains, once it's elevated, will train the ladder round. It will do 360 degrees, and this one is for the extension.
I want that.
The operations for the ladder are, before anything happens, the engine's got to be started. Now engaging the power takeoff. and hear noises. Nothing's happening. The drive is to the turret. The next job is to operate the axle lock. Then we wind down the jacks. All four jacks are now touching, but they're not locked into place. But what has to happen is each jack has to be squeezed once just to lock it.
That's it.
Quick release buckle. And as we're on a slope, we put the release the throttle, release the extension, and release the quadrant. This one, when you operate that, that gauge has to show pressure because it's operated by oil pressure clutches. Once you get that, you can move that upwards and that will start the elevation. And it will go up. There's two speeds. You can go up faster and slower. And you can control the speed with the throttle, which is locked here. That is connected to the engine. Come on, that's it. This vehicle in 1940 was dug out of rubble of Soho fire station when a bomb directly hit it on October the 7th, 1940. Sadly, two firemen lost their lives. This vehicle and the other two were dug out, dusted off, repaired where necessary, and put back into use, and were active during the Second World War fighting German blitz fires. It carried on with the LCC after the National Fire Service, which was formed in 1941 to 1948, and it carried on with the LCC London Fire Brigade, which LCC, as you can see on the side here, is why you've got London County Council. In 1964, she was taken out of service, and along with three sisters was sold off, potentially for scrap. This particular vehicle was bought by a man in Silso in Bedfordshire. The company was called Watling Street Motors, and he dealt with vehicles basically for scrap. But he so liked the vehicle, he kept it for his children. It was put in a barn in Silso in Bedfordshire in 1964, and that's where it stayed until 1980. Gathering dust and nothing happening to it. A friend of mine saw it in 1980, showed me photos, and it took me several months to actually do a deal with this gentleman who was going through all sorts of hassles, and managed to get the vehicle in February 1981. The vehicle had been parked undercover all that time until the middle of 1980, when the barn it was in was compulsory purchase for a school playground. In 1981, friends and myself collected it along with another fire engine that was there, and we drove them back to where I lived at the time in London, and it was parked up back in a London fire station. From 1981 to 1983, restoration work carried out on it, and the red paint you see on the side was actually put on in 1983, and bearing in mind we're 2022, it's not done bad. The guy who did it for me refused to take any payment for it because he liked the vehicle. I had to promise him that I would carry him on his final drive when he passed away. And sadly, a few years ago, I had to carry out that action. The lining on it was done by a fireman at Sutton Fire Station where the vehicle was posted. And that fireman would not take any monies for it. And he did a marvellous job, as you can see, with the lining. And as you can see, it's real old-fashioned style. That is painted on, not stuck on graphics. I owned it with my wife ever since, and she's done now some 22,000 miles with myself and others helping me. The vehicle has done at least 100 weddings. Sadly, it's also done quite a number of funerals, the coffin carried on the back here. She's had various work done to her in recent years. This decking was replaced about 3 years ago. It was replaced in 1983 from the original system, which was still on it. From 1983, it attended quite a few events. The Royal Tournament is an exhibition which was took place right up, I think it was 1997, the last one. It was always at Earl's Court. This vehicle was pride of place in the Royal Tournament, particularly in 1983, where they did a reenactment of the Blitz. And this was one of 16 fire engines of the period. Very, very pleasing and satisfying. She went to Germany in 1984 with six other fire engines, and she went to a place called Kellinghusen, which is in North Germany, for their 112th anniversary. I couldn't understand why 112 was so special, but I soon found out that is their emergency service number, 112. And since then, it's lived in London fire stations, and at the moment, it lives with me in Hampshire, and it comes out to various events. And this is the first time I've brought her out this year. She has been out a couple of times, but things like the rear springs under the back there, they had to be retempered because they're physically sunk. And you know, there's still an ongoing upkeep for the vehicle. And the petrol engine does 4 miles to the gallon, which is not a lot by current standards. And yeah, I'm very proud of it. And my wife and I intend to keep it, and hopefully my son will take it on in due course.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you for showing us this remarkable fire engine. Thank you for the Friends of King Alfred Buses for the open air display day. If you like this video, for more contents like this, please click on like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Hello Wallace. We'll see you in the next one.